Hi, this is a lesson on cuing, but cuing actually starts a step before the actual speaking in class. It starts with understanding your music, knowing how to count your music, and knowing where to place your cues within the music. I'm using a common song, Waka Waka, so go ahead and listen to the song, but watch how I count my music as I'm diagramming it, okay? Here we go. Here comes the introduction. 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now the music just changed. 6, 7, 8. So I moved my little tick marks over a little bit. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Music changed again, so I start another set of tick marks. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Chorus. 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we start back here at the first part again, which is A. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So every time a piece of music repeats, I put my little tick marks directly under the piece of music that's identical. So this is my part B. These are both identical pieces of music. Now we come to the chorus. So this is my C, but C is different this time. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3. There's 4 sets instead of 2. And so now I can see this right away, and I'll know that when I look at my diagram. Now there's no D, so I'm going to move over here. This is new music. This is my E. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And E continues for 4 more sets of 8. 2, 2. My class spins around during this part. This is like the best part ever. I've played this song so many times I could do it in my sleep. Okay, here we go. Now we start back at the chorus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we're in a part that sounds very much like D. It's not exactly, so I could call it D prime, but it's very close to D. I'm running out of room on my paper, so I'm going to call this part F, but I'm going to stick it under part D just because I ran out of room. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and fade. Okay, so have you ever seen one of those cooking shows where they mix together all the ingredients, they put it in the oven, and they open up another oven with the finished product? So now I'm going to do that, okay? This goes away. And then we get this. Okay, so now this is a much more pretty diagram, but it's the same diagram of the same song, and I just did it a little bit more neatly, and I'm going to now zoom in. Okay, so what I did is the little red dots. If you noticed, while I was counting, I made a tick mark every 8 counts. And when I teach this particular song, each count is a 4-count move, like 4 taps is 4 counts. 2 steps to the right takes 4 counts. A shuffle is 4 counts for me. So for me to cue 4 beats or 4 moves ahead of my next move, I have to cue 4 times 4 beats, which is 16 beats ahead. So I put a little red dot over the tick mark that starts 16 beats ahead of my next phrase. So that's what the little red dot is. That's where I start my hand cues. And I raise my hand above my head. I go 4 with my fingers, 3, 2, and when I'm fingering with the finger number 1, I speak a cue. And so you'll see here, under number A, it says 2 steps. So I'm actually doing 2 steps in part A, but I put a little arrow up and over here because I'm going to cue two steps right on the last four counts of my four taps. So my people are going to be tapping, and I'm going to be tapping, but I'm going to say two steps right. And then here, we're going to do our little two steps with our arm flourish, and before we're ready to be done, I'll say four more, three more. This is three cueing for the deaf rather than this. It's also a little easier. Two more, and then one movement before, I'm cueing one with my hands, but I'm also saying right here, shuffle to the right, which is a different move. Okay? So that's how I cue. I use my hands, four, three, two, and then I'll speak for four counts. Now the second time that I come to this, I won't need to speak. I'll just do a little pantomime of the move that we did in the last time we did part A. So I'll make the same arm movement that we did for this move up here, and I won't have to say anything. But I'll still do this, but then I'll do the little arm thing. So that's how I learn my songs. That's where I place my cues, and that's how I verbalize and teach visually at the same time. So the whole song, I only needed to say about 15 words for a 3.5 minute song. Okay, have fun.